I'm Harold Kirzner with the International Institute for Learning. In this program, we're going to discuss the Earned Value Measurement System, EVMS. Years ago, when project management first started, and we began using it on the B-52 bomber, the Minuteman weapon system, the Polaris submarine, we realized the need for some sort of cost schedule control system. We realized that we simply could not guess what the time was on the project, how long it would take. We couldn't guess what the cost was, or up to a certain point in time. We needed a way of getting accurate information on time and cost, and more specifically, project status. The question became simple. Is the project controlling the cost? Does the project manager control the cost, or does the cost control the project manager? Who's driving whom on the project? We wanted the project manager to control cost. And in the early years, it looked like cost was controlling the project manager. So the United States government asked a very simple question. Do project managers control costs, monitor costs, or both? What the government wanted was for costs to be managed rather than just monitored or accounted for. This created a little bit of a problem because the project manager was simply reporting data to a higher level authority rather than managing the project. What's the difference between managing a project and monitoring a project? When you monitor a project, you simply take data and report it to a higher level of management. When you manage a project, you measure the variances, you determine the root cause of the variances, you come up with a corrective plan to reduce or eliminate the variances, you get that plan approved by management, you implement the plan, and then you measure the new variances against the new baselines. This is what a manager should be doing. And unless a manager had the appropriate tools, there's no way a manager was going to be able to do this. The Earned Value Measurement System was created so that project managers could manage rather than monitor. Earned Value Measurement is a systematic process that uses Earned Value Measurement as the primary tool for integrating cost, schedule, technical performance management, and risk. And it's all done on this slide that you see in front of you, where the work breakdown structure is at the middle of the slide. The work breakdown structure is the basis for your cost, your schedule, your technical performance, and your risks. Let me show you what happens if you do not have an earned value measurement system. Suppose I told you you have a budget of $1.2 million. The budget lasts for 12 months, and you have to produce 10 deliverables. Right now, you're at the end of the sixth month. You've spent $700,000. You have four complete deliverables and two partials. What's the status of the project? Are you 40, 50, 60% complete? Without earned value measurement, there's no way of telling. Let me word it to you a little differently. If you spend 20% of the budget, does that mean you're 20% complete? No. If I told you you're 40% complete, does that mean you've spent 40% of the budget? No. We needed a technique that allowed us to answer all of these questions. Without earned value measurement, we focus very heavily upon inspection. With earned value measurement, the focus is on management. What are some of the benefits of an earned value measurement system? It allows us to accurately display status. It provides accurate identification of trends. It provides us with an early warning system that something bad could happen. And it provides us with information which is the basis for course corrections. The earned value measurement system is an early warning system that allows you to take corrective action when the variances are still small. When variances are small, they're a lot easier to correct than when the variances are large. Earned value measurement emphasizes prevention over cures by identifying and resolving problems as early as possible. Now, what questions can an earned value measurement system answer? What's the status of the project? What are the problems? What can we do to fix the problems? What's the impact that each one of these problems may have on the final cost and the ultimate end date? And what are the risks? All of these can be addressed using earned value measurement. There are five critical variables that are part of earned value measurement. PV, which is the planned value of work. EV, which is the actual value of the work accomplished, called earned value. AC, the actual cost of the work you've done. BAC, which is the planned budgeted completion. And EAC, which is what you estimate your actual cost to be at the end of the job, which most of the time is different from your planned budget. Now, these are the questions that each one of these terms answers. PV is the planned value of work. It answers the question, how much work should be done? EV, that answers the question, how much work is actually accomplished? AC, how much did the actual work that was accomplished cost you? BAC, what was the total job supposed to cost? And EAC, what do we now expect the total job to cost? These are the questions that these terms answer. Let me give you a very simple problem. Obviously, time doesn't permit to go into all of the complexities of earned value measurement, but let's go into a simple problem. You're supposed to spend $100 a week, each week for 6 weeks. And right now, you're at the end of the fourth week of the project. Therefore, you're 66% complete. Let's assume that PV, the planned value of work, is $400. The actual accomplishment was only 300. You've accomplished less work than the plan called for. And your actual cost was 325. You spent $325 to accomplish work that was worth only $300. Two simple terms, the schedule variance and the cost variance. The schedule variance is the difference between EV and PV. If the schedule variance is negative, you're behind schedule. If the schedule variance is positive, that's good. You're ahead of schedule. And the same signs apply to the cost variance. If the cost variance is negative, you're over budget. If the cost variance is positive, you're under budget. And the cost variance is EV less AC. If we put all this together, we can come up with the following conclusion for the problem I just gave you. The schedule variance is minus 100. That means somewhere between now and the end of the project, you must perform an additional $100 worth of work to maintain the schedule. And right now, you're over budget by $25. Now, you understand, of course, that we just scratch the surface on earned value measurement. We have courses on this that last 2 days, 3 days, even a week on earned value measurement. If you want additional information on this, the books you see on the screen have additional information on these topics. The books were authored by me, and several of the books were also co-authored by Frank Salatas. At IIL, we also offer other products related to earned value measurement and other project management activities. We offer white papers, webinars, and podcasts. You can identify these on our website at IIL.com. This is Harold Kirzner. Thank you.